mate.
Oh, mate, do you remember that Vice magazine photo shoot?
Oh, that was damaged.
Yeah, it was.
Fucking off the scale, mate.
A bit of peril.
Oh,
oh, some of those girls, mate.
They were fucking off it.
Yeah,
do you know what I mean?
I reckon one or two of them came off the yellow bus, mate.
Oh, yeah,
they were not. They were not there, mate.
They were not
no,
there.
No, they definitely
they were
weren't.
Somewhere else.
They definitely weren't, mate.
That's exploitative.
No, no, they were all paid really. And, like, yeah. You know, so...
And everyone was off their faces.
Yeah.
You know.
Oh, lovely.
Just mental. But, yeah, like, Rufus, he fucking... He lost the elephant, mate. Yeah. He was rampaging. I had to fucking hold him down, mate.
I
spent 2 hours with my foot on his back just stopping him flailing, mate. Because he was...
And he becomes an animal.
I had to basically perform a citizen's arrest, mate. Because he was...
He gets fucking well men cap.
Yeah. He was totally Asperger's, mate.
Models were up for it.
Yeah, they were...
What, they were on drugs?
Yeah.
Well, I think that's really exploitative. I think to get people on drugs and then get them to perform like that.
No, they were on drugs. They would have been on drugs anyway, you know.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
You know.
Well, why does that make it better?
Well, because it, you know,
it's
shows
not an
they're...
issue, really.
No.
I mean, like, if they take drugs, it's cool. If they don't,
cool.
They don't.
Cool.
Like, I wasn't taking drugs that night because, like, I kind of thought it'd be wronger if I was sober and they were, like, on something.
Ugh.
I just felt, like, more wrong to me.
Cool thoughts.
So, like, I wanted to stay straight.
I mean, that girl, Mandy, she was well fucked.
She was
total really
peril,
damaged.
She was
mate.
A complete coke, Gannett.
No, she was
unbelievable.
Really, she was damaged.
Well, you know,
she had good damage, though.
Yeah, well...
Good damage.
Yeah, like,
but
good
But I feel
damage.
Like she... Like, in a way, she, like, damaged part of me. She completely scammed
what?
Me. Do you know
Why?
What I mean?
Yeah, she was quite manipulative.
Yeah, she basically... She kind of, like... She like, orally raped me,
She was... You made me do that document. You said, film this because she's so damaged and you were supposed to be focusing on the film and you got her in there and you lent all that money so she'd give you a blowjob. I mean,
No, that's not how it happened, babe.
And at the time, you thought she was 13.
Rude not to have...
Fact is, she was 19.
Yeah, you thought she was 13.
Fact is, she was 19.
You thought she was 13.
She had I thought she had bonobo syndrome.
What? I don't think it matters. I mean, like, if you find out someone's a different age, like, during sex, like, does that change it?
Yeah, you should stop.
What if it's gone past the point of no return? What do you do then?
You just stop straight away. I mean, it's just...
What, straight away? I think you should have 1 minute leeway.
A 1 minute buffer zone.
No.
Like, if the police come and they try and pull you over, you don't have to screech to a halt. Like,
immediately.
You can get to a lay-by. I think if someone says no, you should have a minute's grace.
What?
They might just be saying it as a one-off, and they might say yes, and then, you know...
That's like condoning rape. That's like condoning rape.
I'm not saying...
I think you've got some pretty outmoded views about sex, Claire.
No, I haven't.
Ashcroft would say the same thing, mate.
Yeah, Ashcroft would not say the
Ashcroft
same thing.
Ashcroft would say some wise
no, he would not.
About
Look,
it.
If you told him no, he wouldn't even know because he'd be that pissed. He'd just think it. He wouldn't know.
That's not funny.
Right. A lot of his twisted genius comes from the fact that he's fucked the whole time.
Yeah, yeah.
Everyone knows that.
Well, I don't agree.
It's part of his genius, though. That's the preach,
what?
Though.
Oh, God, this is
that's
such shit.
It is. That's what he's
it's
about.
It's not
that's
the
what
preach.
He's about.
He's got a drink problem.
His drinking leaves him on the edge.
It's not
do you know
a problem,
what I mean?
Mate. It's
and he needs to be on the edge.
His
that's
work
where people
could be
like
a lot
Ashcroft
better.
Live on the edge. I'm a bit like that. I need substances, narcotic substances, to keep me on the edge, to keep me fresh, to keep me vibrant, to keep me with it.
The whole point there is alcohol, right, is to, like, open up these possibilities.
Yeah.
I don't want my brother to be opened up to the possibility of jerking off builders. If he didn't drink, he'd have a good job and he'd be doing decent writing.
It all flows, you know. Every, you know, good writer is a pisshead. It's a fact.
Yeah, or a druggie. You know, you look at it historically.
Major writers, they've all done that stuff, like Joyce...
Yeah,
he'd get his wife to do all sorts of nastiness.
Yeah,
so that he could fucking write about it. Yeah. Dickens, he jerked off people.
Shakespeare
jerked off a builder.
In
Shakespeare,
the Pickwick Papers, yeah.
Shakespeare.
Go on. What does Shakespeare do?
He got a yeoman to sit on his face.
I don't think it's the same as Dan going into a fucking toilet of a pub and jerking off a bloody builder for some second-rate crap magazine.
Look, that's just all words and fucking judgments. And, like, there are loads of fucking writers who haven't jerked off builders.
And that doesn't
make their books any good.
Name one writer who's good that's jerked off a builder. Or
Dickens.
He hasn't jerked off a builder. He's
Read
talking
the Pickwick
shit.
Papers.
Oh, please.
Shakespeare.
Oh, God.
Tolstoy.
Kafka.
I'm not even getting into this.
Chekhov.
He's a talk such shit.
They've all jerked off builders, mate.
Asimov.
What's the point? I'm not speaking.
Point proven. Thanks.